Welcome back, everybody, here to your live stream of the International 3. We are going into game number 2 here of Mousesports, going up against Fnatic. Tobi 1.
And I am disappointed.
You are? Why are you disappointed?
It's no meatball.
It's, hey. There's still time.
Yes.
There's still time.
I guess.
But then again.
I know Fly. He's not going to pick it. He's going to be like, nah.
Fly actually hates Meepo.
He does.
He really does.
And
hate
he's the drafter. That's the bad part about it.
You know the reason why he hates Meepo? Because he hates the role he has to play when Ira plays Meepo. That's the main reason why. As far as all the other reasons go, they don't really matter, man. They don't really matter.
Yeah, he wants No-Tail to be there supporting with him. But we'll see. Maybe they drafted this game.
Well, let's see. Let's jump ourselves inside the draft because it has begun. It has begun before our very eyes right here. And, well, kicking it off, Mousesports, they're going to actually allow this Batrider again, maybe, to slip through. Is he the Batrider or Razor that will now get through the pool? And I can't believe I'm actually saying that. Razor, definitely
Razor.
Possible pick.
Yeah, it's legit, man.
The first pick does go to Syndra. I think Syndra probably just wants his Chen back again. Or something along these lines.
Probably.
He's got so many options. Lone Druid also hasn't been touched just yet. But Lone Druid up against someone like Razor, it's like you got to micro that bear and pull it away as quickly as possible every single time.
It's a very fast unit, though, the bear. If you have the rabbit on max level and you have the face boots on it, it's a really fast unit. So you can do it. And if you're really lucky, he will link it before even hitting it, and then you can pull it back, of course, with your Q. But, yeah, it's, you know, in general, Razor is pretty good against Lone Druid.
Well, at this point, Fnatic are definitely tossing out what they want to do.
Batrider is available. The Treant is available, sadly.
They already proved that they're okay with the Batrider.
We didn't see Alchemist last time. Did they ban it?
Yeah, Alchemist was banned in the first two.
In the first two, yeah.
Yep.
That hero has such high tier.
I'm going to take out Lifestealer instead. So we get Alchemist as well as Batrider through the pool. And Cinderin says he'll take the Batrider, which means Ira, welcome to your hard farming Alchemist.
Pretty much.
Or not. Black, welcome to your hard farming Alchemist.
Pretty much, or not even, because when there's a Weaver on the lane in the game, Klinks is always a good pickup. And they did play it against it earlier, so they might go back into something like that.
But that means they'll have to go into the lines of having the Lone Druid actually be selected, because they need to have a hero for Koitver as well. If you're going to leave Black on that on the top lane solo with the Klinks.
Oh, you don't have to do that. You can let him solo. Like, if Weaver is going to be solo bottom, then you have your Klinks to just lane against him, which works out pretty fine, especially if you give him sentries, that's a fine lane. And then you can go aggressive lane with Koikwa, and he can play pretty much any of the heroes that he wants up there. Of course, his favorite hero for that is Lifestealer.
The Grand Mage!
One of the absolute best heroes in Dota 2. As far as gestures and sound set goes. His sound set is ridiculously long.
As far as the voice for Dota 2 reporter goes, it's freaking awesome, man.
Yeah.
I am Rubik the Grand Mage.
Dota 2 reporter is amazing.
It is. Actually, we have permission to play those things. We probably should do that tomorrow.
You probably should.
Yeah. So that'll be our filler material for tomorrow, guys. I'll have it all set up. So we'll go through the Dota 2 reporter series. It's a good
all of it.
All of it. It's a good way to actually learn about Dota.
Yes.
Sort of.
Really good way.
Sort of.
Expert school.
Yes.
It's the same as StarCraft 2 reporter. It's a good way to learn StarCraft 2. It's the same guy.
Yes, yeah, it's made by Ronch Animation or
exactly.
Yeah.
Same reporter.
Good stuff. Support the community stuff, peoples.
Yeah.
You gotta watch this kind of stuff. Like you watch this kind of stuff and everyone's like, hey, you know what? YouTube video, it got like 3 million hits on YouTube. What game is that? It's Dota 2. Alright, fantastic. Let's go check out some Dota 2.
Exactly. And turn to ban. This game, they ban out Cinderinix. It's a respect, man.
I can understand the SD being banned out, And Chen, in a way, too, I can also understand that, because Era's Chen is, not Era, Notel's Chen is actually really good. Notel's Visage, however, is a hell of a lot better.
So, yeah, he gets that Visage. He's going to be happy with that, and that
means that... Compendium pick! Yes. Compendium pick!
No Meepo. Sadness.
No. And really, Meepo would be a very... Well, it wouldn't be a good pickup in this.
It would be a reliable and solid pick.
It wouldn't be a reliable and solid pick. You're going up against Rubick, who has a solo pullout ability and an AoE stun on the end of that solo pullout ability. And then Batrider, who has AoE damage and AoE blast away to push all the Meepos back, as well as having a single hero disable. Meepo will not be picked in this game. Sorry, peoples. I got to break it down hard.
Yeah. It's really Fly's fault. This is not No-Tail's fault, guys, so you can tweet to Fly and saying that you hate him. But then again, they might just win this game, so then you don't have to hate him. And we see Puck for Fade Out again.
Yeah, so that means Koiva will be taking up that Batrider. And at this point, too, with the Rubick, it's still very open for the Mousesports lanes for how they do want to run it. If you are thinking about that Klinks again,
It's not so likely anymore, I feel, with these heroes. Should really be a hard-hitting carry more than a Klinks who runs around and tries to shut down the enemy team.
We haven't seen the anti-mage just yet.
Where's the anti-mage?
I know. I actually know that Mousesports don't like picking the anti-mage. It's Black who likes playing the anti-mage.
Yes.
It's a very different approach as far as like what Black wants to do and what the team wants to do.
Black probably sits there right now going, yeah, anti-mage.
Yeah. Anti-mage is really good, man.
He's like, good here. He's good here.
Actually, what Black would actually do is like, I'll take anti-mage and I'll go long lane.
Yeah.
And that's what he'd be saying. He'll be like, no, I'll take anti-mage and I'll go jungle, bottle.
Yeah.
I'll be fine.
He will try to convince Syndran in any way possible. That is a good pickup.
Yep, that it could work in any scenario, any situation.
He's going to be like, yo, they have Dragon Knight. Anti-mage is really good here.
Yep.
All that armor, I don't really care too much about it.
Visage, Soul Assumptions, I'll evade. Venomancer. Fnatic going to take a bit of a leaf out of the Alliance book from earlier today.
Yeah.
Just a reminder, too, guys, that after this game, this is, of course, the second game between Fnatic and Mousesports. Coming up after this, Alliance versus Rattlesnake will be our final game of the day. That'll be our final best of two. But it's, okay, also for people out there, I know have been asking inside the chat why we don't have a countdown of, like, is this one game advantage to Fnatic or one game advantage to Mousesports? It's because it's a two-game series, but the games are considered to be separate. This is the way Valve approach it. That's the reason why we're not displaying a best of two or a best of three display, because it doesn't actually apply to these games. They just played one after the other because of scheduling. It's just a hell of a lot easier.
Yeah.
So this is the reason why we don't actually display it inside the game. So if you are asking for it, if you're seeing other people displaying it, it's wrong.
And it's much easier in terms of looking at how the group stage went if you don't have to look at, okay, who drew against who. And we have the anti-mage.
Anti-mage.
Anti-mage. Someone please find that picture from EMS. That we got linked with Black on Anti-Mage. It was beautiful. Just spam that in the chat. It's going to be good.
It was classic.
He looked so handsome.
It was so classic.
5 seconds so, remaining. Last pickups that are available now. Mouse, of course, need one more supporter.
Oh, remember, Fnatic. Drink, peoples. Drink.
Yeah, drink.
Predict correctly.
Yes. And... we need to see one more hero from Fnatic, though, and they ban out the Bane, as Mouse definitely need a supporter, but...
this is their aggressive lane.
What do
they want? You got Venomancer and Visage together. Even if you just leave it with the Weaver, that's okay, because you don't have a stun, you're not going to be locking down the anti-mage. They're looking for the Rubick and whoever else is up there.
Yeah.
That's the main goal of this. So they can leave DK in the middle lane and just leave whoever on the long lane. Someone that can go up against a Batrider. I'd almost actually throw out there the Queen of Pain as the last one.
Yeah, Queen could work. And I mean, Weaver got pretty manhandled in the last game. So maybe he just wants a rematch, you know?
What?
We see a bench.
What?
That's going to be a tri-lane Venge for sure. Like, Venge is going to lane along with Visage and Venomancer and look for kills.
Who does the deeps, though? Because with the only
she
VS...
does the deeps.
The only person who's been doing that was Eternal Envy. And even when the Venno and VS combo was used in the past, It was Savost who was playing the Venomancer, and he was the farmer and the DPSer. Turn him into a basically this right-click gale of killer heroes.
Back in the days, people have played around a lot with Vengeful on solo mid or on carry positions, and it's...
Really? A VS solo mid?
Yeah. It's doable. You get early level 2 on the swap, and then you start taking team fights with that. You can even do it in a very interesting way with Kunkka and Vengeful, where you have early level 11 on your Vengeful, an X marker, and just swap people. It's like a really good Batrider rip.
How would you go with your item build if you're doing that then?
If you're solo mid?
Yeah.
You just build her as any, like, edgy DPSer. She actually gets, like, a ridiculous amount of damage, and her laning is actually strong. It's just that she is such a good supporter that normally people don't want to solo her. It's like a waste of role. A little bit like the Rubick from TI2.
All right.
And I love that we see the twin-headed dragon.
Yeah. Sometimes one head is better than two. And that's what it will be. And is it Sindarin's twin-headed dragon? There's some good images about that one, too.
Yes.
Sindarin will be taking the twin-headed dragon towards the top lane. He'll be babysitting Black, who, would you believe, has possibly the most sparkly anti-mage blades I think I have ever seen.
Very sparkly.
It is a Nomad's Barbed Edge. They look really cool. I'm just saying. But surprisingly, all of his armor is like uncommon and common belts.
Yeah.
Actually, I can explain that too. One, because he hasn't spent a single dime in the shop. And two, it's because if you actually check through Black's history of games, he has played like one or maybe three pub games in the entire stretch of 2 months. The last 2 months. He's played three pub games. They play, Mousesports guys play a lot of in-houses, the IXDL, and a whole lot of scrims. Or competitive games, because they don't really have time to even think about anything else. So he actually plays very few games, and they chill out to, a game where it's like, you go up against a whole bunch of bosses, the hardest game in the world or something like that. It's a little arcade game.
Yeah.
That's how the Mousesports guys chill out and play and waste their time in the meantime. That's how they take their mind off Dota. And they'll probably keep playing that until custom maps come out for Dota 2.
Probably.
Which is supposed to be coming. It's supposed to be coming.
We're gonna see. This Invis rune is dangerous for Sindarin if he doesn't look out.
They got perfect vision of him as well, as far as like Sindarin goes.
Oh, they're going to try, but nah, they won't.
I'm gonna look around the corner,
Sindarin. They will stay around, Sindarin.
He sits pretty deep here. Sindarin. Era can now stun. And Notel will be able to follow up with a Gale. Pass in the corner. Picks up on Era. Drops down into Fly. And Notel on the Ice Punch on the three heroes. They couldn't go any further around the corner anyway. But they start off with a little bit of easy harassment and say, you know what?
We didn't really mention bear in mind. Black.
Solo mid up against Hani.
Yeah.
Well. 66 times on record since International 2, 41 more times than the second most frequent player. Really?
He is the AM picker.
That's definitely true, man. But
that's a whole lot of AM.
I'm wondering who the other guy was.
Well, I think a lot of other carries would have, you know, because...
25 games in 2 months?
Yeah.
Because I wouldn't put Loader into that mix-up. I wouldn't put Era into that mix-up. I would probably actually look over to the American teams.
Yeah.
Liquid or Dignitas. Howie and Scylla.
Oh, Scylla is...
How could I just not look towards Asia?
Yeah.
And that's probably the reason too why. Like, I am a self-admitted person that I haven't watched anywhere near as much Asia Dota as I really should have.
Interesting to see Farah up here on the top lane. Really shuts down the aggressive tri-laning a little bit from Fnatic. Because Puck on tri-lane is strong. Like, it's not as strong, I feel, as Queen of Pain. Because she is even more devastating on a tri-lane. But this gives them almost no purpose to tri-lane against it. It's hard to find anyone to go on. If they go on Sindarin, he's very tanky. If they go on Farah, well, he's probably going to just jump away.
Pass is basically the only one.
It's going to be very far back. Yep.
And then he's also got that, like, even if he's a long way out from Sindarin, Sindarin's got this huge range ice path.
Yeah. Haste rune now for Batrider here.
Well, he can't really find any kind of opening with this. The only thing he can hope for is to have a bottle, but Where's that courier? It's actually bringing the bottle down to him now.
It has the bottle, so that's very nice for him.
Look at Black Star 2 in that middle lane. He actually really enjoys these kind of matchups. Like, Black will look at this and say, well, I can take away all of Hani's mana to a point where he'll have to run a bottle more than anybody else in the world. That's the way he would look at this lane. And it looks like Koifa, he actually wants to come middle lane. Napalm stack, Hani's got no mana. They start the Firefly. This is first blood right here with two Napalm stacks, and they just hold him there, and they want the last hit in Nanny Mage, and they get it too.
Of course, it's like last hitting a creep. Just sees it like a big bag of gold.
Money, 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 money.
Look at the timing for when he died as well. He died as he had creeps pushing into tower. It's always a sad thing for you. But he TP's back in, so he's gonna not miss too much. Only one creep.
Right, he even finds the last hit by using that breathe fire.
Yeah. So nice little playing catch up there by Hani, but dying, of course, not something you want.
Doesn't spoil it completely though. Like, it could have come in, popped the breathe fire, then popped the bottle, and he sort of been regenerating after he came in. Because the bottle, you can refill even after you've gone bad at the base.
True, but you also have pretty much regeneration from the fountain if you use the spell right when you TP.
Yeah.
But
the
then again,
the bottle holds it for like an extra.
It doesn't matter
second.
Too much, because if he has mana on this lane, it only means he will take more damage. He needs to waste his mana as soon as he gets it. That's why he does this. He spams it immediately. Because having mana against Antimage basically only means that you will take more damage.
I think I'm trying to watch this bottom lane to try and work out why Trixie died before the Koipa. Because it's the same matchup. It's the Batrider versus the Weaver. It's exactly the same solo versus solo matchup that's happening.
Oh,
yeah, they're bringing in Fader.
A little bit.
They're protecting the DD rune. The bottle's on the way in. So Hani, he actually returned the courier to him after he realized he'd have to send it all the way back to base.
Yeah.
And having that DD stored up, a lot easier to go on Black, especially when he starts this one up. If he had drag mana for a Dragon Tail, he could do a lot of damage to Black right now. And Black has to wait this out.
It's downtime, pretty much. Can't do much about that.
This top lane, here is actually like 12 for 7 up here, up against Fader, who's 13 for 5. So as far as that farm goes between this top lane, it's kind of okay. Oh, there we go. Visage has been the most popular hero of the day. Picked or banned 25 matches so far. Yeah.
That's a whole lot of Visage.
Is it the most picked hero, though? And the most banned hero? Like, I'm not saying like the two of them together. Separated. I'm wondering if they actually win, because I got compendium results riding on this.
Yeah, this is important.
Yes. It's very, very important. Compendium betting is very, very serious, man.
I think you have an addiction, Tobi.
Slightly. Hey, man, I got my entire player cards all filled up.
So
Black,
crazy.
Where's this? He's got no stun. Black can still take this, but then again, he's ticking over from the poison damage of Hani, and Hani with his high movement speed. Black
can't die from it.
No, he can't, but he can get bloody close to it. Yeah. And now with Koifa, two Napalm stacks, he can go into a Firefly after the third one here, or he wants to. He's not going to. That's a waste of time now for the Batrider. He left that bottom lane unattended.
Yeah, and that's what he did in last game as well. He won his lane, but then he left it, and then he started, you know, regretting that, I believe, because the Weaver will make the most out of that time that he's off the lane.
Oh, Era.
Era, just a little bit far out there.
Ice Path's gonna hit as well.
If the Ice Path was sooner, they could have gone the Rubik Lift near the tower.
Because then you would have seen the Jaw actually happen into a rift, and yeah, it would have been...
Could maybe have been a kill.
Mm-hmm. We can sit here in our armchairs and go Captain Hindsight.
Yeah, it's very easy.
Yep. We'll do it all day.
I'm fine with that.
We'll do it all day. Fail, Syndrome. Fail.
Horrible.
Yeah. You call yourself a Jakiro. Only 3 in an ice path when the other 2 on the opposite side of the map. Yeah, I expect more. Corp's not looking too healthy here, man.
He's just jungling up the enemy jungle.
There's
and now
bottle.
He has bottle, so...
No 6-minute room for anybody by the looks of it either, or is there something bottled up inside of Hani? Nope.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I think he already used the 6-minute rune.
Black's rotating. Black's coming top. There's no ward looking for him. In fact, he's trying to keep his distance here, but the plague wards are going to spot him instantly as he comes up. He's like, damn it.
What are you doing, Black?
He wants kills. He wants money. He wants Ice Path to latch on Era just like that. Now the Gale, it hits on pass, but not Black. He keeps moving in. He's got himself a mana void, and Nortel's got low mana. He wants a kill on one of these guys up here on the top.
This is downtime again. Like, this movement, I don't agree with it. He could be mid. And just TP top, because he has a TP scroll from the start, but I guess he wants to switch top and lane there.
Looks to be the case. Now Fade is going to come middle lane. So, okay, that explains the rotation a little bit more, but
yeah.
I would have expected like Puck to have a TP scroll or something, because it's taking a little bit too long. And Hani, well, Fader wants to force him out of here, but he's lost the T1 tower already.
Yeah, and that's just from one hero leaving for that time that it took. And the tower is gone.
Koiva's losing time with this bottle. I don't know if it's going back to base on purpose, but this courier went all the way out to the mid, and is now walking around with just a bottle on it, and going all the way back to base with a full bottle.
Yeah, that's not too good.
I'm hoping it's just...
Oh, DD room for Trixie, and Firefly is out. He has to grab this.
Koiva's dead.
If he wants to live in any way.
With the Geminate attack. It's a shame he doesn't have bugs, but the Shikuchi through. It's worth the time-lapse damage. There it is. Time-lapse is out the damage and gets the kill on Koiva.
Top lane as well.
And now stun. Black VS starts up on him. And Notel trying to follow through with the soul assumption. Still not enough damage to kill up Black and then waste a lot of mana. Black can just blink into... Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! Plague Ward didn't attack him either.
And
he went
regen.
Down to 19 HP.
Yeah, the regen is strong enough. Well, I didn't see that one coming as well, actually.
But the Black would turn around into a slightly suicidal situation?
No, just that he would take that much damage from the Visage Nuke again. He almost died to it.
And Ira's doing as much damage to this tower as he possibly can.
Yeah,
he's actually not looking too bad, but this is a very weird kind of thing for him. Like. We've seen the VS and the SF combination most of all of recent. And that's like this negative armor strat that works really nicely. But unless Visage gets a medallion, you won't have this negative armor strat. But Ira, that's what he's leveling up. He's three levels up in Wave of Terror.
They have Weaver.
They do have Weaver. Like, Weaver's bugs are actually really nice. But, like, his armor reduction of one, it's not really something you write home to your parents about.
It is. It's amazing.
It's not amazing.
It reduces armor by one every time they attack, so it's quite okay.
I suppose over time then, yeah, I'll be okay.
Yeah, you just gotta make sure that Dire's the bug lives.
Top tower has fallen. Only downside.
Get a lot of halberds and click them on the enemy so they can't do anything about the bugs.
How fast do the bugs attack? Once per second, or?
Not second, I believe it's like some weird interval, isn't it? Oh, maybe it is second. I'm not sure. Gonna check the attack speed of them next time we throw them out. I have this German tooltip. It's amazing.
Wonderful.
Oh, no, it's 1.35 seconds. Sekunden. Yes.
Yes, because you're reading it all in German.
Yeah, I'm reading it. It's one.
That's good. Yeah. Yeah. The tip for people at home, if you actually hit the alt button, it gives you so much more information.
Some skills actually have extra information that you can read by holding alt button while hovering over the skill in bottom lane. Grab or something.
Are you thinking about it?
Yeah,
he can.
You should have a puck there.
I'm trying to watch the
puck
top lane
close.
At the same time. Where is this
oh,
latch?
Oh, why didn't he grab him? He could have killed. This was a free kill.
I'll be worried more about top lane right now because that's where we're going to see Black blink into the range of the tower. But nice. Nice ice path. Really nice ice path. Fly as well as Notel burning in that one. We've still got that Dragon Tail stun from Hani holding Black there, but Black again able to retreat out 69 HP and living for the moment. Pass gets hit by the breathe fire from Hani. So it's a 1-1 trade for the two supports here. And Cinderin's backing up the tower. Notel puts down some more, try and keep him out as well. And keep the creep wave occupied while they bring down the tower. VS swap. He's got the stun available before Cinderin can get the ice path down. Double kill for Hani. All on that top lane, and Koiva's on the run from Trixie. Trixie's actually going to dive back past this tower in the bottom lane. He's got Napalm stacks on him, Flamebreak trying to bounce it back a little bit more. He's got Shikuchi again, but he's not going to chase back past the tier 2 tower.
Blink Dagger now delivered to the Batrider. They failed at trying to kill bottom. He should really have grabbed him there. He was so close to a tower, and Batrider was invisible, but he didn't try. So, a little bit sad.
And then Trixie goes straight to mid, to harass Fader back again too.
Yes.
You fail on the bottom, and then it has repercussions for your other lanes. And poor Notel. This is like the biggest, droopiest face of a Venomancer you can have.
He's like, I took damage, and I need to run back to base.
I'm not meant to be in this game.
Kill me.
I'm a Hydralisk from StarCraft. What am I doing in the world of Dota 2?
What is this TI3 you talk about? I want to be at WCS.
If only I had more micro skills. I need more APM to play this game as a Venomancer.
Well, we saw that earlier. Didn't attack the Antimage with his Venomous Warp.
That's true.
It's the APM that did it.
That's true. See, Select would have made that.
You would have.
I hope you guys gave him crap about that comment. Trixie, double damage. DK's gonna take the tower. He got the stun! He got the stun of Fader as he came out! Oh, Fader! He didn't jaunt fast enough. That's a very uncommon mistake from Fader on that puck. Fnatic will now roll into this bottom tower. DD room will wear off, but it doesn't matter. They still got the dragon form up, and they found someone else. Era found Koifa. Swap him into the Gale. Koifa can't move fast enough. No Firefly possibility anyway. And then bottom lane, we've got Trixie diving on pass. And he's in. He is so in. He is basically holding it down. And maybe Chihuchi Ice Bath will hold him there. Fade with the silence. But Trixie, one more attack and the generator attack will kill him off. Not even that. The first attack will kill him off. Time-lapse out the damage. DK with a stun. They are killing Mousesports inside their own base and inside a Puck ultimate. They haven't even taken a tier 3 tower or Rags and Blacks is like, well, okay, maybe this is like meant to be free gold moment. I don't know. I'm confused.
Yeah, Blacks is like, what are you doing killing my friends in my base? What's going on?
That's your basing. Wait, what?
Exactly. And CS is so similar. 72-12 or 71-12.
Exactly, oh, VS. Stun. Howl. Brief fire. Jakiro pops. Black can't fight this either. There's your first opening. They get the lasso, swap dragon down. Back, but Black is nailed. You're right, swap is available. He needs an enemy hero. No
DK,
tail!
DK.
No tail!
No.
No tail goes down at the creep wave.
Yeah.
And oh. Now they move over to Hardy. Koifa's behind, and familiar stun doesn't make this too easy. Hardy's got space now. Oh man, 9-5. Fnatic, like, they weren't even just diving back past the tier 3 tower. There was a tier 2 tower that was still up on the bottom lane.
They were in the attack range for tier 4 tower at one point. It's a deep dive, and it still didn't really hurt them that much. They even killed the anti-mage in that. So, yeah. I mean, carry Ventio. Working out.
Familiar stuns.
Fala has going not on had Sindrin. A good game, man. Holy crap.
Are they going to try and go for the familiars here? Resummon? Not available. One familiar. Doesn't get away. And they even want another one. Koifa with his Firefly. He's really sticking with this. Howl of Terror. And now it's, well, okay, Koifa's running the rim. But that Firefly's going to wear out, surely. He's not going to get back to base with this. Or is he?
No, he's fine.
He's got Blink
he
Dagger.
It might be a Rosh attempt now by Fnatic.
Maybe. Well, they got so much, well, I say they got so much negative armor.
Oh, so much. They have Howl. That's like it. But they might go for this mid tower first.
They've really got to win this game too, like really, really fast. If this game goes late, they're screwed. Because yeah, any mage will be able to get on top of them. Like, any mage has got 2 kills, 1 death, and 78 CS. He is still the most farmed hero on the map. And he's just getting straight back into it. He needs that Battle Fury up and running. And then that'll buy... If his teammates can buy him the time, they'll be okay. Because you got Visage, VS, and Venno. You're not looking at a huge DPS, all the best synergy in the world, with both the Weaver and the DK. DK at least is, I believe now that should be a BKB. Yes, it is.
Weaver.
Flying out to Hani. Trixie, time lapse, Ice Path will hold him. And any mage kill secures.
Magic thyself out of that. But then again, Roshan is going down.
It's not magic, man. It's smoke and mirrors. And they've got this. Familiars, they've already got the damage back. Park. I thought maybe we'll see a suicidal, but doesn't happen. He doesn't steal the Aegis of the Immortal. But the Aegis does go to VS.
Top tower is still high HP. They should defend this.
There's the TP, and there's another TP. And Cinderin leaves a nice path behind. Harney's has to stay there. And now into dragon form. He's got a haste rune. Oh, dragon on dragon action. And Cinderin will just pop.
Easy kill.
And Hani's already moving for... oh, look at him move. He's moving for Black's next blink almost. No, he's coming back down. He's going to check out mid. They've got Observer Wards watching this movement from both Pass as well as Fader. But they won't find the opening. Hani just goes back to the creep wave instead. While Trixie still farms up on the bottom lane. He's getting closer towards that Lincoln's. He'll get it by 18 minutes. Or thereabouts. Especially if this tier 2 tower goes down, he'll definitely have it by 18 minutes.
Yes. And this tower is dead.
That it is. Fnatic, man. This is just such an impressive performance by them. Through both game one and now game two. It's just been really well executed by them. They've really come to this international knowing exactly what they want from it. AKA, to win.
To win. Win games.
Quaver. Firefly. Link
nice,
Lasso.
But swap.
He got no tail. And then, whoop! Straight back. Era. Looks like swap got stolen. Now the swap level one got stolen by Pass. Top
tower is oh. Under attack. Look while Black swap initiates.
While Black actually, he's gonna get enough money now. He's got his Battle Fury. He's gonna get out of here though. Blinken just TP Black. Blinken just TP.
Nah, he wants into a jungle and starts farming.
He's 100 gold away from his Battle Fury.
Yeah,
if he actually gets this up, man, I don't want to call this game over. In fact, I want to call game on.
Yeah. This game is not over by any means.
Fnatic are basically going to force into the base right now. They're going to go on Koifa, and now Koifa being attacked. He cannot blink away. The stun, the howl. Oh, wow.
It's a lot of damage still.
It is.
So it's scary because 18-minute Battle Fury is, you know, it's nice that he has it, but it won't stop this push. The Battle Fury is not going to be a solution.
No.
They need to have good team play, good coordination, nice play with Puck and
they need Rubick to steal Venomancer's wards is what they actually need. That's the only way I can see them holding this line. They use macro pyre to take the aggro of the creep wave away from the tier 3 tower. Ruby's got to get there and steal those wards. VS swap is good, but his follow-up is with telekinesis, and his teammates aren't following up either because Black is not there for it. Black is still trying to bring down this tier 1 tower on the top lane while leaving four of his own players to defend that mid. And the funny thing is, he will bring down this tier 1 tower, but this is an okay trade for Fnatic. They know breaking the base is so much more important for them right now. Blink on the tower. Blink Lasso, actually. Era being caught out. He goes down here. But the Aegis Immortal is the only thing that will trigger. And Pass, Hani, well, he was one last hit away from killing off Pass just then. And now Fly being hit by that Park Hold. He got stunned up. He's got a huge Soul Assumption charge, which he's going to throw out. He's battling Dragon on Dragon. Cinderin goes down. And then Black comes in to snipe off the Victor Fly. So he's back here in the engagement. They've still got their mid racks, and AM's still got ulti. He wants someone with low mana, but no one from Fnatic is actually fitting that description.
Not really, no.
Trixie might, however, if he comes back in like this. That's as much damage as he can deal to Black. And Koipa's looking for another opening. He'll see a familiar up in the air, and he'll see the rest of Fnatic falling back. They brought in the tier 3 tower, but still no racks.
Yeah, no racks, but they open up the base, and that's the big part. Next time they push, it's going to be a lot easier. And this Venge is really close to an Aghanim's.
Black. Blinks away from Trixie.
Yes. Trixie is scary.
I'm more worried about VS. As you said, like, that Aghanim's, man.
Yeah, it's going to be big. And she still only got the level 1 swap because she was a carry farmer. So she wasn't really a solo and getting that high level. So she is about to hit level 11. And of course, that range is a lot better, 925. And Black chose to go for Vladimir's, knowing he can't get the Manta Cell in time.
He wants to be ready to fight when the fight begins. He doesn't want to be inside the jungle and say, well, now I don't have any life points to survive, or when I TP back, I've got to heal up first.
Yeah.
He needs to be back and ready to fight straight away. And this also allows him just to split push out. Yes. Like, we've got three players for Mousesports up on that top lane, pushing into the tier 2 tower, while Black is pushing to the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane, solo.
Gives some decent armor as well against all this minus armor from the Howl.
Oh, Honey's already popped Dragon Form.
Oh, are they going to get a level 2 swap?
Yeah, it is.
But no.
Swaps him out, but they didn't get enough for it. He blinked himself straight back in again. Koifa looking pretty safe here. But now he can't blink into initiate. Honey pops the BKB. They want this Rax badly. And there's nothing that Mousesports can do to stop it. Koifa comes in. He was almost trying to bait out a semi-initiation from the DK on him, pulling his attention away from the Rax. But Fnatic have already got their target. Now they can fall back and defend their towers because Black is still farming up. He did some decent damage to that tower, but he doesn't even want to go up against Era.
No, definitely not.
And Hani with 3.1k gold up on him. There's so much cash coming the way for Fnatic. How much is it? It's 12,000 gold advantage going their way. Experience, however, it's actually coming back the way of Mousesports.
It's because they are going as 5 so much. They're getting towers and Roshan and kills, but when you go as 5 this much, the experience you get is not that high. meanwhile, there's Antimage who's farming nonstop. And he alone will pull in a lot of experience. He's level 15, and that is the highest level in the game.
I think Black's now realizing that Trixie just came through here and took every single one of his creeps apart from the Hellbear camp. And you can see him on the lane, too. But he knows he can't fight him. He doesn't have enough life points to really do this. Oh, then again, maybe that doesn't deter him. He's got to get rid of this Weaver bug, burning off Trixie's mana. And, well, he wants to, but he needs to get Trixie down lower again.
Yeah, that's what I meant. Trixie will just ulti after trading a little bit. But Black not really scared. He knows that everyone is bottom.
He knows he can just TP back as well. And by taking out both these creep waves now, the momentum, it's not going to go the way because Trixie intercepted the other creep wave.
Era is not with the team right now. He just wants to farm up his point booster, get the entire Aghanim Scepter. And that is a big upgrade to have that in the next fight. Of course, the cooldown is ridiculous with Ags.
Scepter cooldown of 10 seconds.
Yes.
And then if he can get himself up level 16, so it's a 10-second swap on a 1200 range.
Well, it's not going to be 1200 range yet. It's still 925.
Yeah, when he hits 16.
Yeah, exactly.
When he hits 16.
Not before you're 16.
Sweet 16.
Sweet 16 for Venge.
Let's just, well, judging by the way she's scantily clad, it almost looks like she's sweet 16.
Yeah.
And Swedish? And now I think of the story concerning Bruno.
Story concerning Bruno. He's not blonde, not Swedish.
Well, no.
Anti-confirmed.
No. Anyway, back to the game and not something else. I think that the worst thing is when I look over towards the chat and someone says Uncle Tobi, which is all pass. It's a good thing he's got Shikuchi.
Oh,
he goes Invis and they Gale. They throw everything they've got. They don't know where he went to. One second, Shikuchi. He can Shikuchi again. No, he can't. Besides Familiar Stomp's got the position right.
That's how you kill a Weaver without sentries. Because that's basically what they just did.
They guessed where he was running.
Yeah, but the Venom as a Gale doesn't hit Invis, so that part was failed by No-Tail. But none of his spells hit Invis, both his ulti and Gale miss. Pushing in for mid now.
This kind of feels like going in for either...
They're going for top.
Top racks.
Like they just entered through the mid.
Black just wants this bottom tower first. He's got the Rubik back now. There should be fortification. Yeah, it's available for Mousesports. The creep wave's not really with him here, so they will pop the fortification. And Black doesn't want to come back. He has enough confidence in his own teammates they can hold it out. With four levels up in Fade Bolt, 4 points up in the Orb, and Ice Path, Macro Pyre, and a Flame Break, you would think it would be enough to keep Fnatic out of the base while Black really starts tearing at the bottom. Because he's now even attacking the Tier 3 tower with a Catapult. This is now becoming a bad trade for Fnatic, but Hani wants it nonetheless, and Blink, what, Koifer! Era swapped him out, Fader, he gets a 3-4-man silence, actually. They still lose the tower, but Black just took the Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane as well. He can't fight a counter right here, can he?
Oh, he got the Batrider.
VS swaps away, pass, Park ulti is big, it already brought down the Venomancer. And Batrider is back to safety, Syndrome on 1 HP, he can't go critical from that Venomancer ultimate. And now buybacks, Animage, as well as Rubik, both buying back. They haven't lost this top Rex yet. And for some reason, what the hell is that?
Yeah, it's a really nice
disco,
urn
disco,
glitch.
Disco.
A glitch with urn and something.
It's the grid. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Trixie. There's still a Blink Lasso. This hasn't been used yet. If they trigger that link, it's just like that. Blink Lasso, two Napalm stacks, and then burn, and mana ulti.
Why are you up there?
Why do you ask questions of Trixie that he cannot answer himself?
He can't answer that question, that's true. He has a Desolator in 48 seconds. And Black just blinked in.
And then put straight back out again.
Yeah, because that was a very... very bold
Black,
move.
Why are you there? Trixie, why are you there?
Well, that means that Roshan will now fall to the Dire. Or to the Radiant. Mm-hmm. Not the Dire.
If Fnatic went in there, though, Black could have finished up Roshan very, very quickly. But he went in there with no support, no vision, no even, like, looking before you leap. It was a guess that Fnatic wouldn't go there.
Look before you blink. Was it the flink and blink?
True.
Either way, that death was not something he wanted because he died when he defended the Rakt top, and then he bought back, and now he died again. And this
it's a 25-second window. And with Weaver, who just picked up a Desolator, and is Shikuchiing himself as fast as he possibly can to the top.
Even more importantly so, he only has a Yasha, Vladimir's, and Battle Fury. Mm-hmm. So even if he lived, there's no Manta, nowhere close. So
no fortification either.
Look for a swap.
There's your TP coming back, and Batrider very quickly blinked himself away after TPing in. Could just TP to a safer position and take the blink dagger.
I guess that would be more boring.
Yeah, true. Live life on the edge, man.
It's the bamboo style. He didn't choose the bamboo life.
Bamboo can't see the edge. He just keeps walking.
That's how it works.
So Mousesports now have to clean up the inside of their base.
They're going
to
go for bottom now. No time to push out the bottom lane, probably. Just going to go in here.
Still exactly what they should be doing. Look where Black is. He's down on his own Ancients farming up, while his tier 3 tower on the bottom lane is being sieged by a dragon.
There's always time to farm.
No, this is not time that Black is allowed to farm. He has to come back in defense. So he brings 3 of himself. Maybe he can stop this Aghanim Scepter for Fly.
With his fake Manta style? Yeah.
Wait, his fake Manta style? Yeah, that. There you go. Courier's dying everywhere.
But then he trades his own life, I think. Oh, actually, very nice silence on the Vengeful by Fada.
Yeah, we'll say Puck's able to hold him out, but look at Syndrome just melt. It's a good thing Trixie got picked up in the air, but Venomancer's, he's still able to tick him out from this, and VS swapping straight back, that back runner straight back in again.
Chase, swap one more. Swap the Puck.
He probably can, man.
Swap the Puck.
He wants more life points first.
No, he doesn't. He has Aegis. Swap.
Oh, that's true.
Swap the Rubik.
Is he in range? There it is. And then Rubik as Shikuchi.
Oh.
And then all of a sudden...
This is what happens when no tail... Oh, when they don't have proper supporting. There's no wards.
Oh, pass. GG.
GG is called, so... Fnatic. Strong as ever.
2-0, man. 2-0. And that is going to end that game.
So the bench carry worked. Didn't really hit the early levels that I expected them to give it, but really paid off in terms of just maxing the aura, maxing the howl, and dealing damage with right clicks. She hit really hard in the fights.
All right, guys, so we're going to go a very, very short break here. I was reading something at the international conference that said we might be casting a different game for our last game of the night. But no, we will be doing Quantic versus Rattlesnake. It will be coming up next here on the live stream. That is now confirmed, locked it in, Eddie, all that kind of jazz. And we'll be back here. We'll be back here after a short break. We'll see you soon.